Hello everyone and welcome to Checkpoint. Yeah. All right, let me start by asking you, how has your day been? I know there are so much pressures, the anxiety, the weight. I know with all of this, you have to tell yourself that everything is going to be all right. I believe so, and I believe that things will eventually turn out in all our favor. All right, I'd like to start by saying thank you, and thank you again for all that you do for us at Checkpoint. Thank you for your likes, thank you for your shares, thank you for your comments, thank you for the questions you've asked and have received answers to. Because of all you do for us here at Checkpoint, our message is reaching a wider audience. And for all of this, we want to say thank you, and thank you again. All right, so today on Checkpoint, we are going to be having a very important conversation, and I'd like you to just go ahead and do what you do always. Invite your friends, invite your relations, invite your associates and your neighbors, and let them know that Checkpoint has started. All right, I can't wait to see your comments. So please do leave a beautiful comment in the comment section so I know you are here, and I will be responding to every comment. Thank you so much for coming online to Checkpoint, and please do well to invite everyone you know, your friends, your relations, your associates, and your neighbors. And after the break, I'll be introducing the topic that we have for today. Are you excited about that? All right, please go ahead, invite everyone, and I will be right back after the break with today's topic. Don't go anywhere. All right, welcome back to Checkpoint. Now, today on Checkpoint, I have a very interesting topic for you. And our topic today says, secrets of couples who stay together forever. Secret of couples who stay together forever. Have you wondered that, that for some people, for some couples, marriage seems to be for just a short season, and for others, the longer they stay, the longer they enjoy it. Let me state this categorically, that marriage is not meant to be endured, marriage is meant to be enjoyed. And it is quite unfortunate that most people only endure their marriage and assume it is normal. Meanwhile, some others are in reality enjoying their marriage. Today, I'll be sharing items with you, points that will help you know the difference between couples who endure their marriage and those who actually enjoy their marriage. I'll be sharing with you the secrets of couples who stay together forever. Staying together forever is not just a wish, but it is something you have to take responsibility for. So I'd like you to invite everyone you know and let them know that it is time for Checkpoint, and today we have something very juicy, interesting, engaging, insightful for you today. All right, let me share with you what I have. Number one point that helps you to know reasons, the secrets why couples stay together forever, is that number one, they prioritize each other. They prioritize each other. What does it mean to prioritize yourselves as a couple? It simply means that if you are the husband, you can say, no one and nothing is as important to me as my wife. And as a wife, you are meant to say, no one or nothing is more important to me than my husband. That way you are prioritizing your spouse. Listen to me, prioritizing your spouse is not something you just say, it is something you actually do. Let me say this again, please type it down if you heard me loud and clear. Prioritizing your spouse is not something you just say, it is something you actually do. You have to intentionally, deliberately let everyone around you know that he, your spouse, your husband, is important to you, that she, your spouse, your wife, is important to you. And not just important to you, but the most important person in your life. When you prioritize each other like that, you will discover that marriage becomes easy. From the marriages of Kenneth and Gloria Copeland, from the marriages of Kenneth and his wife Hagen, you see that these are patriarchs who lived long in marriage. From the marriage of my parents had a long and beautiful marriage. You can clearly see that one thing they all had in common is that they were able to prioritize their spouses. They were able to take that one person in their life seriously. There is somebody that when you hear the person's voice, you calm down even in the midst of anger. There is somebody that when you hear their voice in, concerning a particular situation, you can change your mind because they have become involved. So I like to encourage you to make sure that you prioritize your spouse. Let yourself know, let everyone around you know that there is somebody in my life who is super, super important in my life. So that's what it means by prioritizing your spouse. Let them know, let them see it, let them feel it, that they are number one in your life. Any couple that prioritize themselves, they will stay together for a very long time. Forever, that's the key word, forever. They will stay together forever. All right, let me share with you number two, secret for couples who stay together forever is that they accept each other the way they are. They accept each other the way they are. Is it not unfortunate that in this era you see a wife making a husband to look like he really is not, you know, buy artificial things and put on so that it looks like he has the figure, you know? You see husbands trying to tell their wives to go for butt enlargement or breast enlargement or lip enlargement and stuff like that. I always tell people to be careful. Anyone who always wants to make you enlarge something in your life, enlarge something in your body, that one does not really mean well for you. You have to come to the point where you are accepted wholly by the person who you want to marry or the person you are married to. Make sure there is acceptance. Couples who stay together forever, they accept each other the way they are. They're not trying to make something else out of you. They're not trying to change you into something else. They're not trying to switch you or swap you for something else. No, they love you. They love the way you are. They love everything about you. Now, please do not quote me out of context. I do not mean that if you have a very bad habit that they should love you exactly the way you are. Listen to me. If you have a bad habit, you've got to work on it. If you have a bad character, you've got to work on it. You've got to change yourself, because nobody can change you except you. Nobody can honestly change you except you make that decision that you want to change, you want to get better, you want to improve on who you are. So when I say they accept you and love you the way you are, I don't mean that they love rubbish. Nobody loves rubbish. Everyone wants you to be a better version of yourself. And the good you do to your partner, the good you do to your spouse, is to make sure that you improve on yourself on a very daily basis. Intellectually, physically, spiritually, socially, emotionally, you are improving on a steady basis. So couples that stay together forever, they are able to accept each other. Not only accept each other, they support each other in their endeavors, in the things that they do. They show you that they are in support. They show you that they believe in you. They show you that they value you, you know. So if you are in a marriage and that's not happening, it is time for you to pray and trust God, that God who holds the hearts of men and women in his heart will turn it in your favor. Because a marriage where you don't have a spouse who accepts you the way you are, who supports you in the things that matter to you, in the things that you do, in the things that you are really passionate about, that is not marriage at all. It's sort of bondage. And please, I'd like you to know that there's a difference between marriage and bondage. Can we say it together? There's a difference between marriage and bondage. Type it in the comment section if you are following, so that I know that you are catching up with the things I am sharing. All right? So that's okay. Let's talk about number three. Number three secret of couples who stay together forever is that they communicate effectively. They communicate effectively. Many people undermine communication. But can I tell you that communication is the lifeline of every relationship? Communication is the lifeline of every marriage. There is no marriage that can survive or thrive if there is no adequate, effective communication. There are verbal languages, there are non-verbal cues that you and your spouse can use to communicate with each other. In a room full of people, my husband and I can just use our eyes and communicate with one another concerning any other person in the room, and we understand ourselves well. Couples should grow to the point where they are able to understand each other, whether it be verbal communication or non-verbal cues, all right? Body language, eye gestures, genuflections, whatever be the case, communicate, and communicate all the time. In fact, it is over time as a couple, you should be able to understand yourselves. You should be able to be so communicative that you are open, you are honest with each other, and this will greatly, greatly help your relationship. So learn how to communicate. Talking is not communication. Communication is not complete until there is feedback from the person who has been communicated to. And this is what where we miss it. We assume that the moment we talk, the moment we speak, the person we are talking to should have understood what we're trying to say. But it is very possible that you might just say something, and when you are done saying it, the person you are talking to understands it in an entirely different way. And this is why we always emphasize on communication. Understand how your partner speaks. Understand how your spouse communicates. Understand what is important to them. See, it's not just about what you say. It's about what you think, what you say, and what you do. Let me say this again. It's not about what you say. It's about what you think, what you say, and what you do. Because if you think right, you will say right. If you say right, you will do right. So it's just connected like that. So communicate well to your spouse. Communicate well with your spouse. Let them know that you truly love them. Not just in words, but in thoughts and in action. All right? Speaking I love you is not enough. You have to communicate that on a regular basis. But in addition to saying I love you, you have to think I love you. You have to do I love you. You have to show it. See, when God loved the world, he didn't allow us to assume that he loved us. He showed it by giving us his son. When Jesus loved the church, he didn't allow the church to assume how he loved us. He died for us. So it's important that you know that love is not love until it is shown. If you are communicating love to your spouse, you should also make sure that you are able to show it. Show them that you truly, truly are communicating with them, that what you mean is what you say. Don't talk to your spouse anyhow. I made a video some time ago, 15 things you must say to your spouse. I also made another video, 15 things you must not say to your spouse. And I clearly said in that video that it is not just enough to just say it. You have to act it. You have to show it. You have to prove it. And this is very, very important. All right. So there are things to say to your spouse that things you should not say to your spouse. Verbal abuse is wrong. Don't verbally abuse your spouse. You know, you cannot from the same mouth say nice things to your spouse, and then from the same mouth you are insulting him or her. This is not right, and it is very, very wrong. So communicate well. Communicate well. Make sure they understood what you said in the context with which you have said it. If you say I love you, mean it, show it, and then prove it to them. All right. This is very, very key. Let's talk about number four. Number four secret of couples who stay together forever. Number four secret is that they accept responsibility. They take responsibility. They know that marriage has obligations. Let me say this again. They know that relationships come with what? Obligation. Marriage comes with an obligation. You can't say, oh, I'm just married, but I do nothing, I say nothing. No. It doesn't work like that. They take responsibility. Couples who stay together forever, they take responsibility. They know that there is something that they have to do, and they do it. They do it. They don't just accept, like a husband, you can't just accept authority without responsibility. You have to know that leadership is both a function of authority and responsibility. Let's say this again. Leadership is both a function of authority and responsibility. You cannot just take all the authority and the husband of the house and the head of the home, and then you leave out the responsibility. So there are responsibilities for both the husband, there are responsibilities for both the wife. The husband has a responsibility to love his wife. The wife has a responsibility to submit to her husband and so many other things that make a marriage work. I always say this in all my videos, and I say that people assume that the reason why my husband and I are having a very beautiful marriage is because he is a bishop and I am a pastor. It doesn't work like that. We are not doing well in marriage simply because we have spiritual roles, or because we are preachers, or because we go to church, or because we are filled with the Holy Ghost. That can be a part, but that's not all. Despite being filled with the Holy Ghost, despite being born again, we understand that there are roles to play, there are responsibilities, and we do not take those responsibilities for granted. So we do what we have to do in order to make each other happy in marriage. So there is responsibility, and you have to figure out, what is my responsibility towards my spouse? One of such responsibilities is what we call the love language. The love language. You have to find out, what is the love language of your spouse? How does my wife see love? How does my wife understand love? How does my husband understand love? What does love mean to him? And only when you understand the love languages, then you'll be able to know how to love your partner, love your husband, love your wife responsibly, all right? Knowing fully whether there are responsibilities to carry out even in marriage. All right, let's talk about number five. Number five secret of couples who stay together forever is that they are very honest with each other. This seems to be a hard one. They are very honest with each other. Why do I say it's a hard one? In our place in Africa here, men think it is manly, all right? It is manly, it is headship to not tell your wife everything about yourself, to not tell her everything about your business, to keep some secret to her. That's what makes you a man. But that is a wrong understanding, all right? That's a very wrong philosophy. There has to be honesty between both couples. There has to be honesty, transparency of the utmost kind. Even in the Bible, in the book of Genesis chapter 2, the Bible says in verse 25 that the man and the woman, that they were naked and not ashamed. They were together with each other. They were naked and they were not ashamed. They were open to each other. This signifies a level, a deep level of openness. They were so open to each other, they could tell each other anything, and that's how true couples live together, husbands and wives. All the secrets you are hiding is not beneficial. All the secrets you are hiding is not going to help you in the long run. People always say, oh, so that when you die, your spouse will know what you have. But listen to me, it is not only in death that you need your spouse. There was a particular man, a very wealthy man. This man was so wealthy that he had about 4 different filling stations in about where we lived when I was growing up. But do you know that this man, when he died, it was a very sad story. His wife did not know anything that he owned. All right, so she heard in the rumors that husband has this, has that, has that. But she didn't have access to any of them. This man was in the hospital, needed medical attention, and nobody could raise the money needed for his treatment because he was incapacitated and there was no other person to sign the check, no other person to withdraw the money, not even in these days that we had ATM cards. There were no ATM cards then. So this man died. The hospital could not treat him. They could not give him because there was no money. And yet this man had money in their account. It took a lot of paperwork and stuff like that for the wife to just get a bit of what this man owed to be able to train his children. In fact, at the end of the day, the children were chased away from the house that the man used to borrow to facilitate some of his businesses, and the house was foreclosed. Some of the filling stations foreclosed. Eventually, some friends even connived and made it look like this man did not have any money, but this man was a wealthy man. True wealth is not in hoarding. True wealth is not in hiding what you have. True wealth is in the ability to distribute it to others and make others comfortable. So you're not truly wealthy. As a matter of fact, you are very poor if the only person you can help is yourself and your children. If that is the only person you can help, then you are not truly wealthy. You are a very poor person. The only way we know that you are truly rich and wealthy is when the wealth in your life affects people around you, affects others in your family, your friends, people around you, people who serve you. That is when we truly know that you are wealthy. Or less, apart from that, you are a very poor person. So please do well. Do well. Reach out to others and be honest with each other in the marriage. You cannot be in a marriage and then be a hoarder. You cannot be in a marriage and be a liar. Do you know there are people that they lie? They lie like 24/7. They are lying. In fact, there are people that when you meet them and they tell you good morning, please go and run and check the time because it's actually not morning. In fact, you cannot even trust the good morning that comes from them because it's a problem. Now, avoid such people. Not even, I'm never talking of you getting married to them. Stop, avoid such people. Someone who is lying to you, they will lie today, they will apologize, lie again, they will apologize, lie again, they will apologize. Very soon, they will lie about your life and destiny. And they will still come to apologize if you are enabling them. Stop enabling bad behavior. Remember, you both have to be honest with each other. All right, let me share number six secret of couples who stay together forever. Number six secret of couples who stay together forever is that they intentionally spice up their marriage. They intentionally spice up their marriage. Let me tell you that intentionality is the key word. You have to let yourself know that I have to do something. You can't just say, oh, because egusi is made, just pack everything and put it in the pot and put it on the fire. Your soup will never be good. If you want the things, your marriage to be sweet, you have to intentionally go out and bring into that marriage the things that you want to see in that marriage. Many people assume that marriage, good marriage, functions on autopilot, which means that we get married and then we live happily ever after. I know you watch a lot of movies and cartoons like that, but listen to me, that is not the truth. If you want to enjoy your marriage, you have to intentionally bring in the things, the items, the behaviors, the attitudes, the love, the character that would make your marriage to thrive. The ability to forgive, the ability to be honest with each other, the ability to prioritize each other, accept each other for who they are, communicate effectively. All of these things are done intentionally and deliberately. But this point I'm talking about is to spice up your marriage. Listen to me, a healthy farm that has not been cultivated will grow a lot of weed. A lot of weed. The weed might look healthy, but it's still weed all the same. So please make sure that in that marriage you cultivate it, you spice it up, you bring in the necessary things, you bring in the necessary ideas that will make your marriage to be sweet and sizzling and hot. Please be spontaneous. Everything doesn't have to be written on the paper and done by the books and stuff like that. Be spontaneous. Sometimes go out of your way. Book a dinner for two. Go out of your way. Buy something nice for your spouse. Go out of your way. Secure a spot for you and your wife to stay for a while. You and your husband to stay for a while. Please go out of your way and do something nice for your spouse. Marriage was not meant to spice itself up. You both in that marriage are meant to spice your marriage up. And it does not happen automatically. You have to do it by yourself. It won't happen automatically at all. You have to do it intentionally, deliberately by yourself. Spice up your marriage. In fact, I have an ebook on spicing up your marriage. If you'd like to have that ebook, the ebook goes for 2,999 naira and it's just for a short period. If you want to buy it, let me know, inbox me, and then you will get the book. It's important to get that book. It will help show you how to spice up your marriage. But I have a caveat, it's only for those who are married. If you're single, please don't buy it. Don't buy it and keep it for later. Just don't buy it. Wait for then. I'll be right here to sell the book to you then. So intentionally spice up your marriage. Put love in it, put spice in it, put spontaneity in it, put something exciting, sizzling. Marriage is meant to be sweet like that, you know. Stop all these boring things you do. Stop all this way you are living like a cavewoman in your marriage, all right? It doesn't have to be like that. You call yourself names that are uninspiring. That shouldn't be so. Intentionally spice up your marriage. Other people, you enjoy their marriage, you envy their marriage, you look at from afar and say, wow, I want to have what those people have. They are intentionally spicing up their marriage. They are not just behaving anyhow. They are intentionally doing what they have to do in order to make sure their marriage is working. All right? Okay, that has been overstretched. Let's talk about number seven secret. Number seven secret of couples who stay together forever is that they don't indulge third parties. They don't oblige third parties. They know that they are third parties, the extended family, friends, well-wishers, but they don't oblige them. They don't indulge them. They know that they would settle their problems amicably. They can discuss, they can talk about it, they can look, review whatever the situation is, and they can come to an agreement because they know how to look at the intention more than just the action. Yes, actions sometimes reveal intention, but they also look at the intention, the idea behind what their spouse has done. And based on that, they can make their judgments. They're not quick to judge, they're not quick to conclude. They listen to each other and they find out the truth for themselves because they're not assuming or presuming. They know that their spouse loves them. And if he did that, if she did this, then there must be a reason. So they don't indulge third parties. Third parties have been the bane for a lot of marriages that have scattered because people would always side other people. Your friends will side one of you, all right? Your friends may not be in the middle. So please do not take your problems to your friends. Rather, consult a marriage counselor. A marriage counselor will be able to be objective and look at the problem without really taking sides with anybody involved. Family members are, if there's a family member, if family members come, they will take care of, they will take the sides of their daughter or the side of their son. And when they do that, the other person becomes the enemy. That is why they know how to keep the third party in the outer court and fix their problems by themselves. So please go ahead and do this and it will really, really help you. Let's talk about number eight secret. Number eight secret of couples who stay together forever is that they defend and protect each other. They defend and protect each other. It is terrible, a very terrible thing for a spouse to come out in public and they're discussing their spouse in negative light. Don't do that. Don't do that. That's unhealthy. Very, very unhealthy. No matter how close you think you and those people are, remember your spouse should be your priority one, should be your utmost priority. Not even your spouse should be your utmost priority. Defend and protect your spouse so that when it is your own turn to be ridiculed, criticized, or looked down at, your spouse will also defend and protect you. This is how it is done in marriage. This is what makes marriage work. This is what makes couples to stay together forever, because you can't just do it all by yourself. You have to make sure that you are doing it right. Right, so do everything in your power to make sure that you defend and you protect your spouse. Don't allow them to be ridiculed by your family members or people in your family or your friends, anybody. Please keep what is yours. Listen to me. The honest truth is that everybody's armpit is smelling something. Everybody's bum is smelling something. The truth of the matter is that it's only the person who actually goes close that will perceive the smell. Don't make it look like it is only your own spouse's armpit or bum that is smelling. Every other person's own is smelling. It's just that people are far away from it and they don't know. Now, when you carry your inner dirty linens and begin to talk about it in public and put it out there, it becomes a problem. And everybody looks at you like you're the only one who has a problem. But in reality, every other person has, they have their own problems and they're carrying it about secretly. And they're not shouting about it. So don't shout about your own spouse. Don't call your spouse useless. Because the moment you call your spouse useless, you are Mr. or Mrs. Useless. Because you're married to the useless person and two have become one. So please, calm down. Calm down. When your wife is not doing well, calm down. When your husband is not doing well, calm down. Talk to them about it. Talk to God in prayer. Seek marriage counseling. These are the proper channels. If you begin to talk about it everywhere, it's not changing anything. Posting about it on social media will not change your marriage. It will not make your marriage better. What small trouble you have with your spouse, you're already out there posting it on social media. Is your head normal? Are you okay? Did you forget that the internet never forgets? Did you forget that a day is coming when you love your spouse again? And when you love your spouse again, how do you explain to those people you've already thought about your ugly looking partner or terrible partner? So that is why you have to intentionally guard, defend, and protect your spouse. I'm not saying that you should defend and protect somebody who is abusive. I'm not saying you should defend and protect somebody who can take your life away. I'm not saying you should defend and protect your spouse when your spouse is involved in child pornography. What I mean when I say defend and protect your spouse is that you should defend them from people who want to pull them down. Defend, especially when they are doing the right things. So it's not because I say you defend and protect your spouse, even when your spouse is engaging in very corrupt practices or terrible things or inhuman activities, you now say, oh, I'm supposed to defend and protect my spouse. That's not what I'm saying. Don't protect somebody who is committing evil. evil is evil all round. Don't say, oh, I have to defend and protect. That's not part of the category of people I said you should defend and protect. All right, let's move on. So let's talk about number nine secret of couples who stay together forever is that they love and care for each other unconditionally. They love and they care for each other unconditionally. I've heard many times when women say, if my husband wants me to submit to him, then he has to love me. Some husbands say, if my wife wants me to love her, then she has to submit to me. Let me tell you something. When the Bible tells us, husband, love your wives, and wives, submit to your husbands, it did not say submit to them when they are doing well. It did not say love your wife when she is a good woman. No, it just said you should love, and we're supposed to love unconditionally. The Bible told us in the book of Romans that while we're yet sinners, Christ died for us. So don't just assume that your spouse is that you only be good nice to your spouse when they do something nice equally. No, that's a reward. That's not loving unconditionally. You don't care for somebody only when they are also doing something for you. No, that's not love in the first place. So learn to love and care for each other unconditionally. Let it be something that flows from within you. Let your love and care for your spouse be something that flows continuously from your heart every time you're looking at, how do I make my husband laugh today? How do I make my wife happy today? What can I do to improve his life? How can I support her dreams? These are the genuine questions you ask when love is in action, when care is in action, and when they are both unconditional. Amazing. This is something my husband and I will do on a consistent basis, always asking each other, what can I do to make him smile today? What can I do to make her feel supported, feel loved, feel appreciated, despite all that she's going through? These are the kind of questions we ask. And if you're married, I'd like you to intentionally ask yourself those questions, because this will help you greatly. This will help you big time. It will change your marriage forever, all right? So remember that couples that stay together forever, they love and they care for each other. They spend quality time with each other. They want to be around each other. They do not take things for granted. All right, they love. They love and they show that they love. Remember, I said that love is not enough until you think love, you say love, and you do love. Let's say this together. Type it in the comment section so I know that you're following. Love is not enough until you think love, you say love, and you do love. This is so important, so that the person you are married to feels that you love them, knows that you love and care for them. Throughout the session, I've been able to share with you some secrets of couples who stay together forever. Number one, I told you that they prioritize each other. Number two, I told you that they accept each other for who they are. Number three, I told you that they communicate effectively. Number four, I told you that they take responsibility for everything, for their actions in their relationship. Number five, I told you that they are very honest with each other. Number six, secret of couples who stay together forever is that they intentionally spice up their marriage. Number seven secret is that they don't oblige third party. They don't indulge third party. They don't get them involved in their affairs. Number eight, a secret of couples that stay together forever that I share with you is that they defend and they protect their spouse. Number nine, a secret of couples that stay together forever is that they love and they care for each other unconditionally. And number 10, the final one I'll be sharing with you today, is that the 10th secret of couples who stay together forever is that they pray together and spend quality time with each other. They pray together and they spend quality time with each other. It is commonly said that couples that pray together stay together. And when they spend quality time with each other, quality time does not mean that they are watching television or pressing their phones or being distracted with the news. No, quality time means that they are giving each other undivided, undistracted attention. And that's what it means. That is truly, truly what it means to spend quality time. It's not just spending time, it is spending quality time. And this is important for couples who want to stay together forever. They also pray together. They pray to their maker, they go to the altar and obtain grace and favor for their lives. The Bible says that we should follow them who through faith and patience obtained their promises. They know there is a promise ahead of them for their marriage, for their children, for their children's children, and they go to God with patience and with faith, and they obtain the promises. They know that when they pray together, there is power when they pray. You see, one thing that God said, God will always dwell where two or three are gathered. The two, the couple, the husband and wife. The three may be a child or other children. So listen to me. It is important that when you pray together, prayer of agreement, it is powerful. When a couple holds hands and their hearts are united and they pray to God, the God of heaven will answer. I am praying for you and I'm rooting for you that you have a very beautiful marriage. A marriage that will stay, a marriage that will last forever, a marriage that will make both of you stay together forever. That's my utmost prayer for you, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Now, if you just came and you joined us late, I'd like you to please do yourself a favor. Go back to the beginning of this video and watch till the very end. Enjoy this video. Let it bless you. Let it equip you. Let it empower you to become a better version of yourself. That's what we do at Checkpoint. And so until I meet you again, keep making a positive indelible mark in the lives of people and on the sands of time. I love you so much. Bye-bye for now. Mwah. Everyone, I hope you are blessed by that message. All right, so I want you to just go ahead and support us. If you are led, go ahead and just sow into the account right on the screen. And I know that as you do that, God will bless you big time. Because of the seeds you are sowing, we'll be able to reach a wider audience on different platforms. So please do well to sow that seed, and God will bless you. Love you.